Welcome to another episode of St. Vincent Untold Stories. On this episode, we just want to give you an update with some untold stories that have been going on in St. Vincent and the Grenadines. Big ups to all of my subscribers. And if you are new to the channel, hit the like button, the subscribe button, and hit the bell icon if you wish to see more videos like this one. From my previous video yesterday, you saw what was taking place in St. Vincent and the Grenadines. The people of St. Vincent took to the streets of Kingston to march against injustice, to march for equality, to march against unemployment, to march against extreme poverty, to march against high taxes, and so forth. 1-784-454-3536. That is the official Untold Stories number. So no one else can call you telling you that they are associated with Untold Stories. We know how mischievous some people can be. Call the number direct or WhatsApp us to verify. A lot of scamming have been taking place since the volcano relief efforts have started, and we don't want to be associated with anything of that sort. That is why when we go out most of the time, we tell other persons that we are making the donations to let us take some pictures so we can send them to the donors. We don't have to publish them on the big media platform so that everyone can see that we are giving them stuff. We just give the donors accountability. There have been complaints say that some persons are taking this stuff for personal gain. But at Untold Stories, our donors have seen our work ethics. We have heard of instances in which things came in and persons going around saying they are donors gave the entire packages to their families. I'm not saying that they can't give them some, especially if they are evacuees. But when you take all of the items and just give it to your families, it is showing that you don't care about the others, you only care about yours. All my subscribers would know that this program came out long before the volcano erupted, and we was always viral. But now there is an uprising of persons going around saying they are donors, and we are not against that. But if the supplies are coming in to help people, give them to the people. And then there are those again who would pick out the nicest set out of the items sent for the evacuees. Do not do it. Everyone has to be treated equally. You see, when you do things like that, then the foreigners sending in the relief packages gets the blame. You know how we Vincentians stay. We small, but we tall. Remember, there would be those who would say, I be all clattered than body as then. What all, what here, this are bigger, this are extra large. Not even knowing that the persons going around saying they are donors opened this stuff already and took the best set. At Untold Stories, we were added to some group, and we also added some persons. But you know what we did? We never asked for anything in those groups because we saw that it was mostly every man for himself. So we backed out. Where were they before the volcano erupted? How come there was not the voice of the people before? We are not saying this to belittle or to separate anyone. But the way how things are going, we have to be very careful. Even some of the waters that came into St. Vincent, they are in shops. The shopkeepers chose to sell them. When we talk about things like extreme poverty, who best to let you know that? Someone who was a sales rep, who was in the streets almost 365 days per year, who knows the struggles of the Vincentian people. We can show you some things that might surprise you. We can even tell you some of the hardest villages in the red zone, because we have been out there on a daily basis. In places like Fancy, only jobs the people have is farming. Well, if you know the red zone better than untold stories, tell us that we are lying. Show us a job in Fancy in which 25 people from Fancy are employed in the same place. Tell us. In Oya, they thrive on farming and fishing. They have a small arrowroot factory, and they also have a fisheries in which some persons from Fancy are even employed at that fisheries. But they are being paid minimum wages. Some of those wages can't even feed a family for a month. Sometimes the fisheries is closed for weeks, even months. These people have to be home without a dollar in their pockets. Sandy Bay is a place that we love. They thrive on their agriculture and their vending. There is no form of mass employment in those communities. Even when you come down to a place like Overland and Orange Hill, it is even worse. In some of those communities, if you are not a party card holder, tons and tons of goods are being exported from those communities, and you wanna tell me they don't see it fit to build a processing plant, to construct a factory over there? I wanna just say big ups to Simon and his wife and the entire UK Massive who made those massive donations. Remember I told you that Untold Stories kept out of those groups simply because of certain things. And we noticed that anytime persons reach out to Untold Stories for help, Marvo is always fit and ready to assist. And we just want to big up Marvo for her great work. It had times already that persons reached out to Untold Stories, and we badly wanted to help. We was questioning where would we get that help from. But Marvo always came through. Once she had items to donate, she would say, "I would handle it, don't worry." Right now, there are a lot of families still in need. Remember I told you about the ladies from Orange Hill? One of those ladies has a sick child who has an eye problem. And she sent a video to Untold Stories to get her some help. Because it's like every door she knocked on were closed. They were giving her some spin around. Come back there, come back here. No, you don't tell the people that. We have had barrels that came to us to distribute, and we distributed everything. And there is a friend that I have in the UK sent me a personal barrel. And we gave away everything in that barrel. If you see that barrel now empty. And one of my aunts also got a barrel from a friend. And she gave me that barrel to give away because we are underground. We are seeing what is going on with other people. If you notice, when we just started to speak about the volcano relief efforts, we were taking our time with Nemo. But after it got overbearing, the calls kept coming in, and those calls were true. Because remember, we were amongst evacuees, and Untold Stories also an evacuee as well. We were there when some of the evacuees called Nemo to register. And then, like 3 weeks after, Nemo called them back, asking how they were doing, where they were working, how they were living, and so forth. And after that, there wasn't any help or any call back. So when the big man is saying things about numbers not being available and so forth. So how did they reach out to the number the first time? Tell me that. They choose not to call back because they are dealing with their supporters first. There is an old saying, say all scrive, all loss. Please remember this. No matter how scrubness you are, eventually everything would come to an end. Nothing lasts forever. My brothers and sisters, if you can help, lend a hand. Nothing goes unseen under the eyes of the Lord. Good deeds only go unseen in the eyes of men. But in the eyes of the Lord, good deeds don't go unseen. You might help somebody today, and 20 years later, that person is going to remember, you know, that person helped me, and I choose to help back your children. With that being said, we just want to big up the entire population in St. Vincent and the Grenadines, the regional islands and the international countries who are supporting and praying for us during these difficult times. We thank you.